Roland? Jeff, hold for a sec. Jeez. Okay. All right, and 3, 2, 1. Hi, everybody. My name is Matt Stryker. I'm typically the main shooter for ASPP, and I also edit the broadcasts. We're going to take this opportunity in our last show to highlight the team that's made everything possible over the years, starting with Will Kersner. Now, typically, you'll hear our opening theme, which he composed. And it's paired nicely with our sunset logo animation, sunset designed by Kevin Munoz, animation by Edgar Arellano. And then from here, you'll start hearing the strumming of Daniel Sanchez's bossa nova.
This is also where I say some kind of clever little thing like howdy, hello. My name is Rulitos, and welcome to our last ASPP broadcast show.
And when Daniel's done, we transition into our monthly beat, which, as always, is composed by Left Ear, aka Jeff Whitaker.
Each month we like to pair his beat with some kind of little bump theme. So this month we're going to show you every single moon tower in the city of Austin, starting with this one here in Hyde Park. Thank you.
Dear Mother, I suppose if you know anything about the world, then you know devil is another name for God. And I am writing to catch you up on what I have been up to this last eternity. You see, I have come to be, for lack of a better word, his bookkeeper. God's omnipotence has only one limitation: his imagination. He can think anything into and out of being, but in the eternity before mine, he learned that he must only plant the seeds of his operations. Nature must then nourish them, without his interference, into systems he cannot comprehend. So out of a simpleton's desire for complexity, and after great trial and great error, God invented time. But nature is no saint, and time is no angel. In tandem, they create life, and in the same entanglements, they create waste and cruelty. And so to combat these trivial annoyances, he invented me. I sit at the world's close where the anus of God's operations excretes its inefficiencies. I balance the debits and the credits and decide for him what excrements to return to the world as fertilizer and what to feed into the infinite void of my friend's sin. But I write to you with good news, Mother. I've been a cheat. For eons, I've skimmed God's excrements off the top here and there until I've collected plenty to hone into a great power enough to kill him. When his errand boy comes by boat today, I will take the fool's place, journey back to his kingdom, and summon the wrath of... I will kill him. I am grateful that man has been made in his image. But that means the limits of man's imagination are the limits of his. I am no warrior. This will be my first and last battle. My final spell of unbalance has only one sole, single, solitary shot. for the world's liberation, I must make it count.
Hey, who are you? Where's the imbecile? Where's Duncan?
He's sick. I'm his replacement, Bunkin. Pleasure.
Are you related?
How do you figure that?
Just take me to your ship of shit.
So anyway, lovely little spit of sand you've got. Must give you plenty of time to think, yeah? If I had time to think, I'd indulge in my creativity, I think. I fancy myself an artist in my quiet moments alone, when I'm being honest. I don't share that with people much. Seeing you here in this vibrancy, this arboretum of prosperity, the botany of it all, it gets the imagination going. Us half-demigods, we've seen things. We have a responsibility to not keep them from the world, right? I raised this once with my super, told him straight to his face. Whoever said creativity is a sin must have never seen the sea. I'd already clocked out, mind you, but you should have seen the look. Seen the sea. See, I like wordplay.
You just made that up. Who in the history of the world has ever said that creativity is a sin?
Onward then. Right, here we are, the Winds Smith. Dreadful name, hard to say. You got your papers?
My identification? I'm Olam, the bookkeeper of God's final domain at the close of the world. Who else would... Forget it. Here. No, don't.
Hang on. Dear mother, I suppose if you know anything about the world, ha! Is this a letter to your mom? Your madre?
None of your concern.
We're half demigods. We don't have mothers. At least not in that way.
It's an exercise for my counselor, all right? Like a journal. You heard of journaling?
Like a therapist? Where on this island do you have a therapist?
Do you have any imagination? It's an exercise. It keeps the sword's edge sharp, something you seriously could use, by the way.
Hey, that's offensive. And isn't it more like, I don't know, trying to squeeze blood from a stone?
Excuse me?
Just a thought. Feels more right.
Why is my metaphor for journaling not adequate, but yours is? Explain.
I don't know why you need a sword all alone in paradise. What have you got to fight about? Off we go, then. Ow! What the hell, man?
Explain your metaphor. Why is it better than mine, Bunkin?
Didn't I just do that?
I'll end you!
Why don't I need a sword?
Shit! That smart's really bad.
What makes your metaphor so good?
Ow, 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 I don't know anymore.
Which metaphor is better, Funcan?
Oh.
Heavenly Father, I I will mince no words. I am your bookkeeper. I'm here to end you. I've lost my arsenal, but I now challenge you with my own strength as a divine test of will.
Wait, lost? You mean you've had one good bullet for me and you wasted it on some mere guy?
You saw that?
Are you stupid? I'm God! I can think you out of existence.
Wait, please no!
Damn it. Was he important? I made this idiot an essential piece of keeping the entire world together. Why would I do that? What does a bookkeeper even do?
Thank you. Not sure. Not sure. Not sure. Not sure what happened here. Not sure. Not sure. Not sure. I'm not sure what happened here. Not sure what happened here. Not sure why I keep coming back. I hate who I've become. Why do I keep coming back to this? Why do I keep going back to this? Let's try again. Let's try again. Damn. Is this really the same place? Is this really the same place? I mean, what the hell? Why can't it always be like this? Why can't it always be like this? Why does the darkness feel like truth? And the light like a lie? Why does the darkness feel like truth? And the light like a lie? I've been in the same room over and over again. Some days it's the last thing on my mind, even while I'm alive within it. Other days it feels like every inch of me is trapped in its own version of this room. Other days it feels like every inch of me is trapped in its own version of this room. When I'm in one room, the other feels like a fiction, an impossibility. When I'm alone, no memory of the times I was a companion can fill the loneliness. When I'm alone, no memory of the times I was a companion can fill the loneliness. Maybe we're not meant to feel everything at once. Maybe there really is nothing else than right now. Maybe when we are down, the only thing we're meant to do is get up.
To the JCPenney after Christmas sale, where you can save 50% on lots of very merry things throughout the store while quantities last. So get to JCPenney and save 50% before it's a wrap.
What's the biggest idea since the Snake Light? Introducing the Snake Light Mini. It fits in anywhere, and it's popping up everywhere. Very clever, Black & Decker.
Did you know one of the moon towers is haunted? Supposedly, several murders happened near the moon tower at Guadalupe in West 9th. The most prominent was an axe murder credited to the servant girl Annihilator. Legend goes, the servant girl Annihilator, aka the Midnight Assassin, was one of the nation's first serial killers, and the moon towers were built to combat his killing. Following their construction, he got spooked and fled to England, where he became Jack the Ripper. While the last of these murders occurred 10 years prior to their construction, it's still a fun part of the Moon Tower history. Anyway, back to the show.
So what? Should there be space in between the dice
drawn? You can do... Let's do this one. So how about... So what if we did eighth notes on every... Not eighth notes. Hi-hat on all one, two, three, four. Then what if we do the bass on one, and then the snare drum on three?
Okay. So...
So it's going to be like one, two...
Release the pain, thinking I'll never be enough to be loved. Yeah, I've been running from these thoughts, running in circles, catch my breath, and I'm sorry for all of the mess. Is there anything left? Is there anything left? Is there anything left? Is there anything left? It don't feel right, no. Is there anything left?
marks. I can't believe there wouldn't even at least be a marker of some kind.
Answer about the South and that being a big part. I think the South has its own type of cosmic. It has an intense cosmic gravity, I guess, or energy. Gravity, energy, whatever. You know, space reference.
It's so topical.
Yeah, but I don't think. If, let me see how I can frame it. If the sun is the reason why Earth continues to thrive, then the South is the reason why the United States continues to thrive. Everything that happens in this country, the country revolves around the South, whether it wants to admit that or not. There's nothing that happens in this country that doesn't come from or out of the South first or primarily or isn't, and if it didn't come out the South first, well, then the South is going to take it. and throw it at some, take it to some extreme, good or bad, mild, whatever. But the South is really. If you want, when I consider what's truly American or like what's truly, it's weird because it's a contradiction. What's truly like American, the South would be that. The South is everything America hates to admit about itself or wants to know about itself. It's like that mirror that it wishes it can just, you know, get rid of and cover forever. But then at the same time, because of that, the South is kind of treated as this far off, distant place that doesn't harbor anything worth anything. It's, I guess whenever I leave the South, whether I go west or north, the way it's spoken about, it's as if it's this, I lost my thought.
You can join the alien agency, meet creatures from other galaxies, and squish them. Take them to the lab, put them on the slab. The agency is out there. Alien agency, sets sold separately. Mega blocks.
Did you know Austin is the only known place to still use moon towers? And by only place, we mean literally in the world. Well, at least confidently in the US and probably the world too. Detroit used to have a ton. Minneapolis had one. New Orleans, San Jose, and Wabash, Indiana as well. While 31 towers were originally built in 1894 and only 11 still stand, as far as we could find, all others have fallen by the wayside of development, age, and more efficient ways to light the city. Austin started a project to restore the historical landmarks in 2022, so they should be around for a while yet. But anyway, back to the show.
Shot into orbit with a Gorgon stare. She stands defiant but clothed in fraudulent regalia. Her diligence forgotten and ignored. The meaning mutilated by design of the destroyers of the ancient world. Their weapons are the empty minds of men, bred into their captivity by fear of losing everything. Of losing everything, the freedom gained.
Thank you. Have you ever looked at a television commercial and thought, I could do that? I'll bet you have. Well, why haven't you done anything about it? Is it because you're afraid to take a risk or you just don't know how to get started? Faces International is in our second decade of exposing quality talent, men, women, and children, to agents, casting directors, producers, and studios worldwide. But does Faces International really work? You bet, and we have hundreds of success stories to prove it. Give us a call.
For your free on-camera screen test, call 416-920-FACES.
Strike the right note this holiday season with two of today's biggest superstar artists. Mariah Carey, her new album Daydream, featuring the hit singles Fantasy, and her latest single One Sweet Day, a duet with Boyz II Men. Also available, Michael Bolton's greatest hits 1985 to 1995, containing 12 of Michael's chart-topping hits and 5 new songs. The new albums from Mariah Carey and Michael Bolton. Two perfect gifts for any music lover.
The ones that we do have, I know that they don't take them down unless, like...
Right, they're ginormous.
Yeah, they're ginormous, and it's a historical thing, too. Yeah. They can't just take them down.
Yeah.
So...
We'll do it in the lab.
If it's either wrong or it was never there. If it's
or,
the lab, they can touch it.
You were taken out by a vehicle and then replaced it.
Yeah, that might be true. The truck driver probably hit it, took it out.
That's great.
Well,
we appreciate the help.
We continue the hunt. Thanks, guys.
All right, man.
Do you think this was it?
This fucking has to be it. That's totally it. This is it, because this is the same build, setup.
Are you sure?
1,000%. All the other ones had the same base layer. Yes. This is it.
I mean,
well,
it's...
Well, not this pole, but...
This. Certainly this pole is telling a story about this empty space. Should we put a sticker on the... on this? Well, at least we got a little something exciting.
If you ever want to fly like bird, swish, pass like magic, air like Jordan. Well, I've got the way to make you play.
My name is Christian Alfred Benavides, or you can call me Coach Al. I'm the head of the Coach Al's Al All-Star Basketball Camp, or the CAABC. Let's teach you the three Fs of basketball. Fundamentals are the most important part of it all. It separates the champs from the chumps, the pretenders from the contenders. We're gonna teach you how to dribble with ease, shoot with strength, and pass like a true All-Star.
Hey, you gotta be careful next time. What's your name again?
I'm Jay.
You never played basketball before?
No, sir.
Welcome to this camp. It's a good camp.
I never played basketball before. I only played soccer, so I'm excited to learn more.
So first thing we're gonna do today, we're gonna do a little dribble. All right, who knows how to dribble? Raise your hand. You know what that is?
Dribble.
Yes, all right.
Coca-Cola.
3, 4, move.
He found me at the arcade. He was like, you ever play basketball? I was like, does NBA Jam count?
Come on, let's try it. That's what I'm talking about. Just like him.
And then he said that if I came to his camp, he'd give me some pizza. So I'm waiting for that, you know?
4 bounce, ready? And go. Perfect. Okay, why do you like basketball? Why'd you come here?
I want to go to the league, maybe.
That's what I'm talking about. I used to play in the league, you know that? He knows. Tell him a little bit about me. He used to be pretty good, right?
I know Al from back in our high school days. I was pretty good on the basketball team, and Al was there.
Let me see the ball. Who has the ball? Boom, perfect. So, next one. I just need one. Boom, that's one. Boom, come on, everyone, let's get started. Come on, boom. Come on, boom. Come on, boom. Come on, boom. Come on, boom.
What do I think about Coach Al? I wouldn't call him a coach.
You never done a layup before? Let me teach you how. Boom! But you're gonna make it. All right? Keep it going, guys. Come on, let's keep it going. Let's do it again. Come on. Ooh, wow. And I not too fancy, Romeo.
Come on. You got this. Here's a little blocking drill.
Ooh. Oh, let's not do that again. All right.
Jumping. You're dang right, little John, sitting on the couch. You do need great conditioning to be a legend. That's why I'm gonna teach you a little bit about fitness. And left. And left. And right. And left. And right.
Not the most rigorous, but that's good sometimes.
Strong core? You bet your belly you need a strong stomach to excel in the fourth quarter. All right, let's get lifting now. You don't have no weights on that, son. Come on, put the weights on that. What is going on right here? Let me show you. Ready? What's your name again?
Mikhail,
nice to meet you. Welcome to America. Ready? 3, 2, 1, in. One, hold it here.
And
2, and 3, and 4. And 5. Come on. Whoa. Annie.
I'm hungry.
How do you think it's going?
You're doing great.
But how do you think I'm doing? Should I make it harder?
I mean, you've got it in you. I've known you so long. I know you can do it.
Right. What I'd like to hear. Let's fucking do this. The most important shot in today's NBA game is what? It is the free throw. When you're at the free throw line, someone's cursing you out from the other team and you need some stuff you gotta do, you gotta make the shot. Who here thinks they're clutch?
Well, let's find out then.
Oh, penalty kick. Oh, you can't get the penalty kick.
Michael Jordan, Larry Bird, Papa John.
I shoot. Oh! You come from a place that's cold year round, huh? We call that Montana here in America. Romeo, where's Juliet at, huh? You wanna be in the league, huh? You wanna be a big boy? Huh, you wanna be a big boy, be in the league, be in the big boy league?
Would I recommend this camp to others? No.
So you probably shouldn't say that. You should expand the answer. So maybe whichever one you like better.
Get out of my face. He knows so much about basketball. No.
Look, I've worked with a lot of video crews in my life. And when I see potential, I hate to say it, All-Star. I think y'all could be All-Star
video people if y'all want to be.
Did you forget the first three letters? Fundamentals? Fun's good, right? You know what's better? Winning. You know what stinks? Losing. So have fun, but be a winner first. What are you doing? Can you tell me the last time a 3 won a game in the NBA Finals? I can tell you how many times. Dude, if you ever shoot a 3 ever again, I'm kicking you out of this camp. All right, guys, you've been in this situation pretty much every time before. 5 seconds left on the clock. 5, 4, 3, you can't get around. 2, and shoot!
Tiny man.
Not that hard. Like, okay, think of this like a soccer goal.
Uh-huh.
Right? Here's the ball. Just gotta get it in.
Do I kick it?
It's that simple. Just, no, that's illegal here.
Okay.
All right, we're gonna stop this shit. How many times did I tell you? Once? Twice? 3 times?
No, it's working. Nothing's there. Come on.
Pick and roll time. Block here, move there. Come on. Screen. All right, you need to be better than that. Because that's the spin and roll, it's the pick and roll. Watch, go. Ow! What are you doing?
I'm just playing.
I thought we were friends.
Are
you trying to embarrass me?
If you've got extra, you know, money laying around that you don't really want.
Can't cut! Hey. You stop this!
Cut!
Screen!
Cut!
Screen!
Cut.
Did y'all have the sound on for that one? Okay, look. This could be y'all's big break. Okay, no one's listening to me. It's all falling apart. I don't know who is gonna step it up, because it's not me. I'm doing great. Y'all, I need to do better. Is that fair? Okay? All right. Thanks.
All right, guys. Time for a real game. 3-on-3. The emphasis, pass. Pass. Okay. Pass first! Ready here, pass! Woo! What's up, man?
I'm in the shot, man.
I said pass first. This is a pass first drill. You're gonna pass all day?
Oh, man, I've had it with your bullshit.
I can tell
you don't play basketball. One-on-one, you and me. Right. Coach Al.
Yeah, I'm Coach Al. Who do you think you are?
After I'm done with you, pal, you have to play a different sport. Maybe tennis or something.
All right. Okay. We're just gonna travel. Alright, check up where? Huh? Come on. Oh! Whoa! Alright. I'm no good. No, not my thumb and my foot. Oh no. That's my foot and my thumb. Oh, it's not good. Don't leave. Please don't leave. I can't wait. Help me at least. I can do this from one foot, okay? Come on. Don't go. Don't go. Whatever. Never need y'all anyways. Woo! Okay, so that last bit, that last one-on-one, not in the video. Get this cut pretty quick. Maybe by Friday. That would help. Friday, you think? After you work harder than anyone else and you've sent in your check, you'll be a certified Al-Star. So remember, call now to 1-800-CAA-BBCC.
I knew nothing about basketball yesterday, so I know a little bit today.
And if you call today, you'll get your own certified signed water bottle.
Ooh.
With water by Coach Al.
I don't know, I might have just stayed home.
But you gotta call now. I'm serious, call now. We're flashing the number, you can see it.
It's probably the only way they can take it down.
Hey, they got it loose. They're coming down with it.
Because it's real, real tall.
And we're going to be taking it down and restoring it and putting it back in 3 or 4 months.
And when it's off, it's really, really dark.
We have taken measures to get some street lighting put in temporarily while it's going to go be taken down and get restored.
There it is, it's on the ground. All right. Yeehaw.
It's like a landmark. We get used to it, and we sure will miss it. Even though it's going to be fixed, and you know, but it'll be greatly missed while it's gone.
Ten and a half. We'll call it 10 and a half.
Yeah, we found the remnants. I guess there's only one thing left to do.
Wrap this bad boy up?
Yeah. Let's go.
Now, it's time to put December into perspective.
Notable today in history. 2019, the World Health Organization. On this day in 2019, the World Health Organization first learned of viral pneumonia cases in Wuhan, China, later discovered to be COVID-19. Then all that stuff happened, prompting some Austinites to start a local video project. 1999, Vladimir Putin. On this day in 1999, Boris Yeltsin resigned the Russian presidency. Thankfully, Prime Minister Putin stepped in and was elected full-time next year. And everyone lived happily ever after. Born on this day, also dead. 1869, Henri Matisse, French painter beloved by algorithms across Pinterest and Instagram. 1600, East India Company. The British Stock Company was founded to fuck over commercial trade with India and East and Southeast Asia for 2.5 centuries. They dealt in cotton, sugar, spices, tea, and opium, and dabbled in colonization, the privatization of military force, and also slavery. 1948, Donna Summer, the queen of disco, best known for hits like I Feel Love, Love to Love You Baby, and Last Dance. They hold up too. Play them tonight for New Year's. Born on this day, not dead. 1937, Anthony Hopkins, legendary Welsh actor, best known for his role as Hannibal Lecter and his less celebrated work as the original Cape Crusader and mentor to Antonio Banderas in the 1998 classic, The Mask of Zorro. 1977, Psy, that one Korean rapper that went viral for his Gangnam Style music video. Remember that? That was 11 years ago. 1965, Nicholas Sparks. Novelist and screenwriter, he's the LeBron James of PC, Middle America, romance, and heartbreak fiction. Thank him for The Notebook, A Walk to Remember, and Dear John, among others. 1943, Ben Kingsley. Legendary actor, best known for his dramatic, empathetic roles. He won the Academy Award for Best Actor in 1983 for appearing in Brownface as Mahatma Gandhi, where the English actor depicted the Indian activist's plight against British colonialism. Different times. 1995, Gabby Douglas, American gymnast, part of the Fierce Five or Final Five, who in 2012 became the first American to win gold in team and individual all-around events, as well as the first African-American to win the all-around title. She's very, very good at gymnastics. Died on this day, still dead. 1991, Soviet Union. On this day in 1991, the Soviet Union ceased to be a thing after Rocky Balboa beat Ivan Drago via KO in the 15th and final round of their unsanctioned international bout. And that's how Russia was born. 1972, Roberto Clemente. On this day in 1972, Puerto Rican right fielder Roberto Clemente died in an airplane crash. He was headed towards Nicaragua with relief supplies after a recent earthquake. Following his death, the National Baseball Hall of Fame changed its rules so as to posthumously induct him into the Hall, the first Caribbean and Latin American player to receive the honor. 2021, Betty White. On this day in 2021, legendary comedic actress Betty White passed away after suffering a stroke. Best known for her roles in The Mary Tyler Moore Show, The Golden Girls, and a legendary SNL appearance as host. Recent dead, still dead. Thunderbird Coffee. The Maynard staple announced its closure in early November. While they'll live on via the always tasty Birdbird biscuit, their coffee and outdoor patio will be missed. Their limited parking spots will not. Louis Shank's Furniture Store. The local furniture distributor is calling it after 78 years in the game. They went out with a huge sale, clearing out all of their remaining inventory. No word yet on what is going to take their place at its Anderson location. Cycle East. After serving the East Austin biking community for over 10 years, the bike store and repair shop is calling it quits, celebrating with a community campout and one final ride around town yesterday afternoon. Honestly, it's a pretty cool way to go out, y'all. Pacha Cafe. Originally located in the Rosedale neighborhood in a cozy, repurposed house with a tiny, tiny kitchen, the organic breakfast house relocated to Guadalupe, same spot where an I Love Video used to be. Today was their last day of service. Those pancakes. We'll miss you. Craig Stewart. South by Southwest collaborator and head of the Emperor Jones label, the behind-the-scenes Austin music legend passed earlier this month. He worked with acts like the American Analog Set, the Crack Pipes, and the Mountain Goats, among others, and helped further cement Austin as a musical hub ever since the 1990s. And finally, some frameworks that make you go, damn. In total, ASPP has showcased over 50 individual sunsets via fewer submissions. Those sunsets have featured 45 cities across 25 states. Internationally, our sunset submissions have showcased 19 cities across 15 different countries outside the U.S. In that same spirit, we thought a lot about how to sum up all of ASPP. Similar feelings, good feelings, even amidst the changes. But numbers and dates and figures only show so much of these past 4 years. You know what I mean? Ultimately, we thought it best to show you instead. Thank you. And that is your ASPP in perspective.
I'm going to hold here because there's a car that's about to stop. So just hold. Don't move.
Don't pray.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Is the car behind me pulling out?
Yeah.
It's the... Okay. What did we learn, Palmer?
Don't shoot in a parking lot?
Don't shoot... Don't pick a parking lot to shoot in.
Don't do a parking lot?
Shall we?
Curtains? Our final hand waves?
Oh yeah, hand wave.
Thanks y'all, really, I really do appreciate it. It means a lot.
All right.
Curtain?
Curtain.